this morning in pet care as we get our lawns and gardens ready for the season. We've also got to remember our furry friends. So back out with us this morning is Carmine DiCenso. He's the executive director over at the Providence Animal Rescue League. You've brought your friend here who's very comfortable in the sun.
She's loving it. This is Sophie, my dog. She's actually a Parle alumni. But she's loving it out here. It's gorgeous.
Yeah, well, it is gorgeous. Perfect time of year for us to get out. I know a lot of people are taking care of their lawns, and let's start there. Putting down a lot of fresh soil, mulch, fertilizer, whatever it is, can also cause some concern for pet owners.
Absolutely. Be very careful where you're walking your dog, especially if it's a freshly groomed looking area and you don't know what chemicals are being used. And you yourself, if you're doing some lawn work, make sure that bag isn't accessible. Your dog's going to get into your shed and bust into it. So be very careful about those things.
Right. Or purchase the ones that are pet friendly. I know a lot of companies are starting to do that. Now, as dogs and cats and other animals start venturing outside, we know there's a lot of wooded areas around here. What should we be on the lookout for? How can we protect that?
Flea and tick season. I mean, those ticks are scary. They carry a lot of diseases that you don't want your animals to get. Oh, and Sophie's rolling and stuff. there are so many products to treat for fleas and ticks, and I wouldn't recommend one, but I would recommend talking to your veterinarian. Make sure you're getting something that's safe for your pets.
Okay. Does it vary just depending on the size of your dog as to which
Absolutely. You have to dose it correctly.
Okay.
And make sure you're purchasing the right kind for your pet. And not every one will work for every animal, so you really... There's different products out there, and again, talk to your veterinarian about what's best.
That's when you need that second opinion. Look at her. She is just loving
it. Completely relaxed.
Little sunbather over here. Another thing that we have to be on the lookout for is dog parks.
Yes.
Now that the snow is cleared, it's, you know, the rain, the puddles are gone. A lot of people are going to be going out to dog parks. What are some safety tips to keep in mind there? Maybe even if you've never gone to a dog park before, what should you consider?
Yeah, I mean, I think the very first thing you need to think about is your dog and make sure your dog would do well in that situation and would actually like a dog park. Mm-hmm. People assume they would. And also, if you don't have a dog that's good at coming when called, that's not the place to test it because they're never going to come to you.
Yeah. So,
you know, I would
just... a lot of distraction at a dog park.
Yeah, and check around your neighborhood. People know the dog parks and they'll tell you, you know, kind of what the climate's like and what dogs are like there. Mm-hmm. So again, just talk around, just don't just show up at one day.
And you mentioned a kind of a strange thing, if you have an outdoor shed.
Yeah, you know, it's there's so many free roaming cats or, you know, indoor outdoor cats, and this time of year we get a lot of calls about someone missing their cat.
Uh-huh.
Come to find out it's in a neighbor's shed or garden because you leave it open all day while you're doing yard work, you close it up and you didn't know there's a cat maybe hiding in there. and also wild animals,
it can
you know
happen. Yeah,
rabbits, squirrels, I mean, they're all nesting and having babies this time of year, so maybe before running that lawnmower, give it a shake or a tap, make sure there's no critter kind of hanging out in there.
Perfect. Look at that. We are all set to keep our pets safe. If you want more information, head on over to roadshow.com.